Hello everyone, welcome back to the sixth episode of The Russian Empire at War. So, last episode we successfully annihilated, and I mean annihilated, the French. Pretty much every speck of land they owned throughout the world. Apparently this isn't owned? Apparently you can't own that. That's news to me. So really, the only major resistance we have left are here in Japan and the Union of Dutch Soviets here in, what, Sumatra? That's really the only resistance we still face. So with that being said, we're going to attempt to finish off the Dutch Soviets. And we will also attempt to... Oh, I also have some land forces there. I forgot about them. No, we will need to liberate Japan here. Our Japanese allies are probably pretty desperate for us to do something besides hold the line. You know, we're very good at doing that. We give them military supplies in their darkest hours, so they actually should be thankful for everything I did for them. They're lucky to still be alive, most likely. Otherwise, you know, our faction, you know, all-powerful, common term, Russian Empire. I forgot we own this land right here. We'll have to do something about that, I guess. Alright, let's make a small push here. Alright, are we working on naval stuff? Can we... How many divisions can we naval invade with? Okay, so we have 50 we can naval invade with. That'll work. That will work. Alright. We could threaten Britannia here, but we have no need to do that. Why do we want to threaten Britannia? They haven't threatened me any. So with that being said, we have no reason to go to war with them. We're going to push at the French though in North Africa here. Morocco and Algeria. Hopefully we can push them back some. Looks like the Commonwealth of England decided to take over the French colonies there. Good job, England. I am proud of you. What wars are raging? Is every war involving the French Empire? No. The Union of Dutch Soviets is also a Internationale faction. Otherwise, it's just people at war with France, so the game should theoretically end once France falls. So with that being said, we should reposition some troops to invade Japan to hasten the end here. Do we have any free troops anywhere? Where are you guys at? Are you there? 49? You are there. I don't want to bother you. I guess we'll have to borrow some troops from the surrounding of the Rhine Confederation. How many do I grab? 21? That should be the perfect amount, I would think. Who is our most competent general here? Ivan Konev. Alright, you're a panzer leader. Very interesting that you lead panzers, considering the Russian army did not use panzers. They used, well, T-60s and other tanks. But, irregardless of that, I guess we'll have to make our naval invasion plans out of, Vladivostok, or... I don't even know how you pronounce that with a question mark in it. Alright, let's redeploy everyone to Vladivostok. And then we will attempt to make an assault on the Japanese Empire here. We're going to attempt making a breach just north of Osaka. I think doing that, we will, we should be pretty successful. I don't, think Japan has too many divisions. Gotta be careful. This is the Japanese Empire. Japan actually is its own separate country that is, well, largely dependent on me for survival. Apparently the Japanese Empire is 110 divisions, though. So we might want to get some air support, which I don't think we have. Not really. One thing we could do, though, is bomb them into submission. That could theoretically work. I don't think the Japanese Empire really has any plans. But, yeah, we're gonna move a bunch of bombers, and we're just gonna bomb the crap out of them. Hopefully that will, help us out a little bit. Alright, every strategic bomber we got, bomb the home islands. See, we're making some good plans here. Look like we're pushing in North Africa just enough to annoy the remaining French forces. And in Sumatra, we are stalling out, unfortunately. But it looks like we are ever slowly moving towards where we need to. I cannot believe the Dutch Soviets are still alive. Once we take these two victory points, they should be done, in theory. One would hope. I don't know how you can actually have victory points on three different continents. Outside of your major region, but hey, they managed to do it somehow. Wonder if we should bump these guys up to motorized to make them fast. Nah, because then the whole army would want to go in there. Effectiveness would go down. Where are my guys at for this army? Man, they're just cruising along here very slowly. We must have really bad infrastructure. Yeah, it's only like level 1 and 3 and stuff. Yeah, not so good. Oh well. We're still... all we're doing is fixing damage. Okay, that's fine. We can handle that. Alright, how many... The French have 11 divisions. Napoleon VI must have retreated to North Africa. Or Madagascar. Or Ceylon here. Or modern day known as Sri Lanka. Or he retreated to the Maldives. That's possible too, I suppose. I don't think the French have any European holdings left. Oh, they do. They have Jamaica. Historically British. But that's okay. So, I'm really glad Mexico joined me, though. My Mexican friends have done an excellent job so far. Apparently the Ottomans are wanting to defend Alaska for me. Thank you, Ottoman Empire. I appreciate it. Alright, in the meantime, while we're waiting for our troops to go, we will attempt making a raid across the straits here. I believe we'll probably end in failure. It'll be like the Italians attacking the Isonzo River in World War I, where they, I think, had like the 9th battle of the Isonzo River, and they still had pretty much stalemated the entire time. So, hopefully we can have more success than the Italians, but nothing's guaranteed in that regard. Okay, so let's throw a few more troops in there. Into this offensive here. I don't see a reason not to. We have plenty of troops surrounding the Rhine Confederation. They won't non-aggression pact me, but if they know what's good for them, they will... they won't threaten me any. If they know what's good for them. Okay, so... I mean, we're still going to work on stuff here. I think we need to work on Air Force to get the extra research slot? Yes. So we'll still work on researching that stuff, but it's of little importance. The war is pretty much over throughout the world. If we can cut these guys off from supply, that would be... It'd be bad. It'd be like a massacre. I only really have 9 divisions attacking here. That's probably why it's taking so long. There's no port here, is there? No. Yeah, all we gotta do is cut Sumatra off, and they will have no supply whatsoever. Well, they really don't have much in the way of supplies to work with anyway. They look to be pretty low on that regard. That's what happens when you fight a lot of big battles as a small country, though. Where are these guys? Oh, there we go. We're just crossing the Mongolian Straits border. Yeah, we're into Mongolia. The homeland of the Great Khan. Republic of China has Mongolia as a core state. I don't think so. I think it belongs to the Russian Empire. Yes. Japan, we are coming to help you one of these years. You have very... Oh, you're scraping the barrel. That's probably not too good for you. I think you have, like, the least populated home island, or core state for Japan. At least on... Oh, actually, you don't. Hokuriku here only has 2.17 million. Otherwise, pretty much, yeah. Even though I think Okinawa is a core state as well. Yeah, 649,000. Okinawa is not really considered one of the Japanese home islands, though I do not believe. And there's Iwo Jima. Also a core state for Japan. With a little over 1,000 people. Man, how many troops do you get out of that? Probably... One. You get one recruitable and one civilian. So every month you get one new civilian who goes to die for the Japanese Empire. Probably not a pretty good payoff for their civilians, if I had to say so myself. How have we still not cut them off from supply here? Probably because we don't have very many troops. There we go. Because we lack an offensive army on Sumatra. Very slowly killing the Dutch Soviets. But we are being very effective nonetheless. No, Turkey, I do not want your expeditionary force. Stop trying to give me your troops. They have no supply. You have to supply them either way, so... Alright, we're almost to Mongolia. We have 1,000 transports. We have naval... Thought we had naval superiority. We do not. So that does not appear to be very good. Alright, so you need another, what, 30 days or so to do that? Where in the world did my ships go? Now come here and defend. Do your job, ships. We need to take the Japan here. How are these Dutch Soviets so resisting us so much? What do my infantry designs look like? Oh, that's probably why. We don't actually have that weight of a combat with. Alright, more infantry. That should make them more effective. And I don't think it'll hurt our infantry equipment so much now. We're also training a ridiculous number of divisions. Not that we need to, but I don't know. Figured we'd do something. Yes, take that city there, Batavia, if that's what that is pronounced as. How goes the air war? Pretty good. There's many thousands of damage here. Let's look at the... Oh, there's enemy fighters active. That's not so good. How many buildings have we bombed? 41.3, so we're doing pretty good. Hopefully we're disrupting their supply and infrastructure. Of course, the bombed out infrastructure only hurt us, but we'll get over that. That's fine. The United States of Australia very convincingly looks to be the real United States, but it is not. Alright, I think we're done with engineering. We could get nukes. But I don't foresee us being around that long to need the nukes. Jeez, the Great War will be over in 1944, pretty much. Alright, our invasion force is pretty much ready. We do have naval superiority. We need our 10 days to launch the offensive, though. Let's speed it up a little bit more to get there. Oh, there we go. There's a few Dutch ships. Looks like there was a little battle going on. I think most of the Dutch army was stuck behind. They look to be largely spent. Why did that not change the victory counter point counter thing? Are there other victory points that I need to take? Please don't tell me I actually have to take the South African ones. That would be ridiculous. Yes, this is stuff owned by France. It shouldn't count for the Dutch Soviets. Alright, we just need to finish them off. Okay, so we're getting close there. Our Japanese... Seriously, we lack naval superiority again. Where did the ships go? Did they go to repair? How many fleets do I need patrolling this? I'm sure I should actually reposition some to Vladivostok, but I'm feeling a little lazy right now, so we're not going to do that. Do I have any fleets available not in the Mediterranean? Black Sea? No. So all of my ships are here. And they all claim to be busy. Alright, so are you repairing? What are you doing back at base? Why aren't you patrolling like you should be? I don't know about these ship guys I have. They don't seem very motivated to do their jobs effectively. Might want to reconsider. We might want to fire them. They're doing a pretty terrible job. We do have a big naval engagement down here. I wonder if that's what's tying up all my ships. I have separate divisions, so I don't see why that would make a big difference. Oh well, we'll figure it out one of these years. Maybe the war won't end until 1945. You know, let's start atomic research. It shouldn't make a big difference in the war, I would imagine. But I mean, seriously, how can... This place was worth 5 victory points, and they didn't seem like they... Unless... That's not a... Doesn't count for them? Oh, I need to attack South Africa. What am I doing on Sumatra? I probably should have looked at that. Now I feel stupid. That's okay. Now we know. So we have no logistical way to get to South Africa. That's reassuring. That is really reassuring. Is there any naval ways to get more range? New ships would get more range. So should we start working on new ships? Maybe. This is gonna drag on the war, I think, a little bit. Oh, there we go. We broke in here. We have a port. Can we attack in the north? And with success? Probably not. Probably not was a good yes. Okay, let's try to spread out our beachhead here. If we could take Osaka, the war will likely be over. As we will be able to stretch our advantage out on the home islands. It's weird it gives me this as land, because you would think the Japan would get that. But apparently Japan doesn't have a claim on it. For whatever reason, of course. Oh, they're trying to tie me down by attacking, I see. It's not gonna work, Japan. We're on to you. We are on to you. No, stay there. What are you doing? No, stay there. Yeah, there you go. Oh, I see what it's doing. It's assigning 20 divisions. Why, I have no idea, but... There we go. That's a little bit more spaced out. Can we take Osaka? If we can take Osaka, like I said, the war should be won by us. Alright, we're pushing on Japan some more. Alright, this is looking good for us. So this is just a colony state, so the victory points don't matter. Wow, I can't believe that. I fell for that. Well, now that we know that, we will just finish sweeping down the island here to destroy their ability to resupply. And hopefully we can finish Japan off. Other than that, I think the war is going to linger on into 1945 while we, I don't know why I'm doing that instead of upgrading my naval capabilities. Lack of planning. Alright, let's see what Japan's made out of. Not too much. They're losing quite a bit of their heartland here. No, you should continue attacking there. It's keep it up, guys. Don't turn around. Can we attack in the north with any success? Probably still not. No, we're still getting stalled out trying to attack over the straits. Well, we're doing our best, but we are getting stalled out. We have 12 divisions to take the bottom part of Japan with, and we have 9 divisions in the north for now. If we can win either the north or south, Japan will fall. It's looking very likely that they will fall at some point. We are winning. We're advancing on the home islands. Japan, we are here to help you. We're helping one Japan and hurting another. Alright, let's see if this wide frontier helps. Because we're attacking on multiple fronts here. So that should give us a combat bonus, but it appears to not be worth very much. Alright, so this island's probably going to be the last to fall. Man, I just wish we had better air support than we do. I wish we had close air support instead of what we have. But it would take too long to get good air support, so there's no point in even starting now. We're just going to have to muscle this out the Russian way. Throwing men at the problem. I like to say that a lot in the series. I realize that. Hiroshima, we will make you fall, and we are going to encircle you. Well, we're going to try encircling you. Oh, this might be our breakthrough here. Nah, we had him encircled, but we lost the bonus. Well, do I trust my allies to hold this line? I guess is the key question. And my answer to that is, I have to. So we can redeploy. Alright, go from the line islands to... Are there any Japanese naval ports not on a city? There's one here by Tokyo. Let's do that. Maybe that's not a valid province for invasion. I deleted your old plans. Oh, maybe because you haven't arrived in the area. Maybe that's why. That makes sense. Well, should we try attacking Hiroshima again? I'm sure it'll descend in failure. It has every time. Alright, maybe if we try pushing north? Nope, we're stalling out. Japan has stalled into a quagmire, much like Operation, geez, I forget what the U.S. plan to invade Japan was called. But that would have also ended in stalemate. We take Kakura here across the, maybe if we take the southern island, we can figure something out? I don't know. Here, let's try Nagasaki. No, we're getting stalled out in Nagasaki, too. Well, this just is not our day, is it? This is not our day at all. We haven't made really any progress at all to speak of. Just kind of sad. Okay, so we've accomplished our goals there. Should we try taking Ceylon? What do we have naval range in? I guess we're going to have to try taking Ceylon out. I guess would be a decent goal. Why do you guys not want to do what I want you to? There you go. I guess we'll land in the south of Ceylon and see if we can go from there. Sumatra is pretty much ours. Their units are just going to die from attrition. North Africa is slowly becoming ours. I don't think you guys have any orders. No. There, guard that stuff. Be useful. Uh-oh. This isn't good here. We're suffering some encirclement. I need to keep a better eye on that. We need this port back. Actually, all of our units are cut off from supply. If we don't get this port back, that could end poorly. Portly? There's a nice pun there. Alright, we got the port. Okay, what could we work on? Naval production. More dockyards will give us more ships. We need destroyers with longer range. What are these guys doing? No, don't do that. What are you doing? That's not what I told you to do. Okay, irregardless, okay, you're gonna go home. That's fine, I guess. Man, what are you guys doing? My units are confused. Which shows quite heavily. Alright, this is like the fifth battle for Hiroshima right here. Still stalling out. We need to rethink our battle plans. Japan still is holding. So that's a good sign. We might need to get a Marine Corps developed or something. We need to figure something out. Our current plan is not working. Alright guys, I think we're gonna end this episode here until we can get a different plan figured out. But I thank you guys for watching. Next episode, we will be ready to finish off Japan and South Africa. Still don't know how that's... Oh, I know why it's a core state, because of the Boers. The Dutch Boers. You know, the First and Second Boer Wars were fought over South Africa. Which makes sense historically, now that I think about it. But when you're not thinking about it, it makes less sense. Why are you guys not... I must have told the wrong guys to do the wrong attack. That would... Really, you fools? You're gonna let the line crumble? My troops are special. We'll go with that. I thought you guys were supposed to be defending that. You don't seem like you're doing a very good job. Oh, now you're gonna fan out, okay. Yeah, my troops need some help. And it's not in the manpower department. Oh, they're part of that army, I see. So, Ivan, you're getting promoted out of there. You are going to join this army. And join the Northern Front, I guess. Can you do that? Apparently not. Wonderful. Maybe if I take some new troops. We'll get this figured out eventually. Alright guys, I thank you all for watching. I know this episode, really, we didn't accomplish anything, except a bunch of realizing how dumb I was. But hopefully we can figure that out soon. Alright guys, I thank you guys all for watching. Hope to see you guys again soon. And I guess I'll thank you again for watching. See you guys next time.